are you smarter than a fifth grader questions.
You're about to see how dumb I really am, me too. Honestly.
So we have like papers that we cut, and then we're gonna like write our answer. And then we also have the questions on my laptop, and it has like the answers on them. All right, let's just get started.
Question one.
How many cups are in 28 fluid ounces?
I don't know what fluid ounces are. Like a cup of water?
You don't?
Is that like a cup of water?
I'm not telling you.
I just guessed. Are you doing math?
Yes.
There's an equation? 3, 2, 1.
14? Okay, the answer is 3.5. 1 point for me.
Okay. Whatever.
Next question. What white puffy clouds are known as fair weather clouds? I honestly don't even know how to pronounce these words. 2, 3. Stratus.
I've put the cumulonimbus.
Neither of us are right. The answer is...
I almost put that one
cumulus.
Too!
I'm probably pronouncing it so wrong! Between 1455 and 1485, the War of the Roses took place in what country?
I'm learning about this in history.
Ready? France.
I put France too. Is it France?
It's England!
I almost did. I was thinking like classy, like what would I relate roses to?
I know, that's what I was thinking, like romantic, France, roses, you know? Yeah. A common type of radio wave is referred to as VHF. What do the letters VHF stand for?
I put very high frequency.
I put variable high frequency.
Oh yeah! Liv got it. That one right!
If Trace is facing north and turns 90 degrees to his right, what direction is he now facing?
I put east.
What?
Hell
what
yeah!
South.
Never eat soggy waffles!
That's 180 degrees! The classic Hans Christian Andersen fairy tale, The Real Princess, is better known as The Princess and the What?
What'd you put?
Frog.
I put frog too.
It's pea. Princess and the pea.
That's an awful name.
Which word contains a long vowel sound in the following sentence? Dogs like tennis balls.
I was gonna say balls, but it's not even an option.
I'm guessing.
3, 2, 1. Dogs?
I think it's like. It is.
Did you put like?
No, I put dogs.
Aw.
Budapest is the capital of what
Budapest.
European... Oh. Is the capital of what European country?
Do you really know?
Nope.
Okay.
Hungary.
Portugal.
It's Hungary.
I was confident about that.
Now a national historic park, what site was headquarters for George Washington's army in the winter of 1777-78? Ready?
Mm-hmm.
Valley Forge.
Bunker Hill.
Valley Forge.
It sounds familiar now.
Yeah, I just said that one because it sounded familiar. What is the simple predicate in the following sentence? Taylor body slammed her opponent.
What's a simple predicate? Can you not share that with me?
No. That's the answer. Ready?
Mm-hmm.
Opponent.
Taylor.
Oh, it's body slammed.
Oh no.
By definition, a prism is a solid figure that has how many congruent bases?
Six. Four.
Two?
Got that one wrong too.
In 1821, Moses and Stephen Austin received 18,000 acres of land in what would become what U.S. state?
Okay. Texas.
Utah.
I said Texas because of Austin, Texas. Oh, yeah!
Texas.
I was right.
Which of the following is a homophone for the word one?
One.
Yep.
Nice job!
Thanks! If you take the square root of 16, I'm really good at math, and add it to the square root of 9, the answer you get is what square root of what other number?
Wait, what's a square root?
Not telling you.
We're gonna go for a solid... Okay.
49.
14.
It's 49.
How do you do it?
Mexico is bordered on the south of Belize and what other Central American country?
I literally have not known one. Guatemala.
Honduras. What? That's not right!
It's so right. Don't.
No, it's not!
It's right.
Which of the following is the scientific term for an organism that makes its food from inorganic materials? Ready?
Yeah.
Autotroph.
Embrophotroph.
It's autotroph.
Did you get it wrong?
No, it's autotroph. When paired with a helping verb like have or has, the word go turns into what word in the past tense?
No. Turn it around.
Yeah. Going.
Gone. Past tense, man. It happened in the past.
Yeah,
going means future.
I don't know. Which of the following words can be used as an adjective? Smooth, rapidly, or smile?
Smooth.
That one was kind of easy. Round the number 350 to the nearest 100. This is a really easy one, Liv.
Well, not if I get it wrong, I'm gonna just even look stupider. 400.
400.
Really?
Yeah. Which of these rivers lies entirely within the U.S.? Colorado River, Mississippi River, or the Yukon River? Mississippi River.
Yeah. I do retain stuff.
If Kevin plans on visiting the three tallest mountains in the world, which continent will he be visiting?
Asia. Oh my God.
We got it right. The last question!
We need to add up all the data.
We do. We'll add the total and we'll put it on the screen here if we won.
Do a dance if you won. Yeah! Bye!
Alright.
Bye, guys! Love you!